now become accustomed to online banking. We buy items from the internet retailers and active participants in the social media arena. However, all these are internet platforms and they are prone to cyber attacks whereby hackers can access your personal information and exploit this for personal gain. Well, October is Cybersecurity Month, and you'll recall that earlier this week on Morning Live, we spoke to the chairperson of the committee, the task team, that looks into this month being Cyber Awareness Month. So we joined this morning in our studios in Johannesburg by the Deputy Minister of Telecommunications and Postal Services, Professor Hlengiwe Buhle Mkhize. Deputy Minister, very good morning to you, and thank you so much for your time.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for coming through. Now, talk to us about what your department has actually noticed when it comes to cyber attacks.
Well, as you know, our policy is to really make sure that we create information society by using different platforms of technology so that people are connected online. And in the process of distributing these technologies, you find that young people in particular, they get attracted to other sites which are too risky and dangerous for them. So this, we are using this month to say, much as we are saying 2030, we want to have a digitized, inclusive society, but people must be aware of the risk that they can come across of online. You have mentioned what is happening in our banks, yeah, where they say fraud is going into billions. Because if people attack your account, and maybe you are a big corporate, by the time you stop it, a lot of money would have left the account. Mm-hmm. But the risk also for humans, women in particular, women trafficking, is really on the rise, whereby they are attracted online by so-called well-meaning, trustable people, only to find that there are no jobs that they were recruiting them for. Some they end up being drug dealers, mm-hmm, some they end up being used as sex slaves, and some are killed by cruel and inhumane ways. So it's really an important month for us.
Mm. And it's not just about women. I believe children are also prone to such cyber attacks. Talk to us about the program that your department has in terms of bringing awareness about these problems.
Yeah, our division, gender, dealing with gender, youth, women, and the disabled, they launched a strategy going to different communities. It was launched in KwaZulu-Natal, where they were really showing people that we distribute gadgets to schools, we make sure that they have data, they are connected for educational purposes. But if parents don't work closely with their children, it's human nature. They don't stick to what is in the curriculum. They go astray and find themselves having conversations, even with pedophiles or with men who will be bullying them online and using the inappropriate language, talking to them. And we say to parents, be your friends, your child's friends, mm-hmm, online, so that whatever they talk about, you can sit down with your child and talk about rights and responsibility, children's rights and responsibilities. The same applies to teachers. We do the same.
Mm. And technology has surely taken over our lives, Deputy Minister. But are people aware of the consequences of the usage of technology?
Well, that's what we're trying to do. Number one, of course, with us, it's like a contradiction, because we are saying to everybody, acquire skills, be able to work online, because all government services will be online tomorrow. If you are in rural areas, you can access a doctor everywhere. But at the same time, while you are promoting astuteness, you're saying, once you are connected, though, you never know whom you are connected to, mm-hmm, across, you know, in the internet. So it's exciting, mm-hmm, in the sense that we're saying to people, this new era, the new policy is saying, it's not about people in big cities, it's about people everywhere. As long as you are a South African, you should access, be connected, and the speed must be very high so that you deal with communication effectively. But at the same time, be aware of the risks that you can
encounter. That's so important. We're using technology every day in our lives, but they've got to be aware. But then the people mainly that are victims of cybercrime, where can they report such incidents or perhaps find more information on the issue?
Yeah, that's one of the things that most countries are expected to do, that they come up with cyber security hubs. In this country, it's led by the Minister of State Security for understandable reasons. Governments start thinking about being attacked, not now by warriors, other countries, but online. And us, of course, as the lead department. So we launched a cyber security hub last year. It's at the CSIR. I think we'll take a walk there on Friday. Basically, it's an opportunity also to skill our young people so that they are competent in analyzing information and be able to understand the risk and see the risk. And as I'm saying this, I'm sure you're fully aware that our universities, they don't even have computer science engineers program in big numbers. You'll find one or two here and there. So what we have done, we have an agency in EMISA. They train people so that people could, when you pick up a risk, you are threatened, you can be able to report. So the cybersecurity hub will be analyzing all the risk and determining what it needs to be taken up seriously and what needs to be ignored. Because sometimes there are clowns online. You can be upset and say, this one has been bullying me throughout the day, following me, and find that it's just a clown. Maybe looked at
so you
face.
Wouldn't really know.
But agencies will be really working on it.
All right, but I believe that is where the ICT policy review that was recently launched by Minister Gwele comes into play here.
Well, that policy is important because really it's something which is creating awareness to South Africa, especially the industry, that look, traditionally they got spectrum licenses from government and they did what they wanted to do in big cities. But the new policy is saying we'll have open access starting in rural areas, protecting even people in rural areas because they have got different threats. You might find out their threat is about what is coming online from a weather point of view or some people who have set up a internet somewhere in rural areas to recruit young people, like that young person who was caught at the airport going to join some terrorist group abroad. So it's a national revolution. The police is talking to that. The private sector, they are our allies in ensuring that we start in rural areas amongst the poor because we are creating a connected, inclusive society for all.
All right. Now, Deputy Minister, that's where you're going to leave it. But I don't know, will you be comfortable enough to talk to us about the state of the postal services in South Africa? Yeah. Because it looks like things are falling apart. Just a quick one on this one.
You know, the post office is not left out on this one. Just recently, the UN Postal Service was meeting, and South Africa won. We've been bidding for a bus which will connect us with SADC. But now we'll be having a post bank, which will also strengthen the post office. We're moving towards a digitized post office so that people don't go only for a letter. You can go in, they have footings all over the country. So the idea is that people in rural areas must be assisted to access information, put through applications if you're a university student. Unlike what we had when the post office was having a labor problems that UNISA students couldn't send their assignments. But now it will be assisting people online, used for financial services, all the things that people require in rural areas.
Because it looks like a lot of branches are closing down now.
Well, they've been closing them down, but the ones where people are located, you know, there was a concentration. In Sandton, you'll find there are five driven by commercial needs, but closing down in rural areas. But we have said, look, the strategy within this ICT policy that was launched 2 weeks ago is that you start in rural areas.
All right, no, that's where you're going to leave it. Professor Mkhize, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Siyabonga. Deputy Minister of the Telecommunications and Postal Services, Professor Hlengiwe Buhle, talking to us about the government's role in protecting citizens from cyber attacks. We're taking a break. Morning.